In this video, I'm going to show you how to do live videos and make them happen with LinkedIn, which is a fantastic place for your organic marketing. I will cover how to request access at LinkedIn, the requirements and tools you need, and what settings to choose when you are about to stream with platforms on going live. I will also give you a walkthrough demo on how to go live with LinkedIn, with OBS Studio for PCs and with Ecamm Live for Mac. This is the replay of a live broadcast with LinkedIn expert Brian Howarth, who will contribute his expertise as well. Also, make sure to subscribe to my channel to see related topics of going live and being informed about upcoming videos, about how to go live with high professional videos and win clients with ease. So now to the topic. This is something that is absolutely the same as a lot of people say with live video in general. You get more reactions, more comments, more engagement through live. And here on LinkedIn, this statistic was actually saying the same thing. And during confinement, during COVID, the live streams on LinkedIn exploded by more than 400%. So it's a general trend, but of course LinkedIn is in there. And now, how to get on LinkedIn Live. And this is, of course, I think the tricky part here, but there are some criteria. So the big difference on LinkedIn Live is that you cannot go live as easy as you would do with, for example, native Facebook app or with Instagram Live. There are some criteria, and still these criteria are not the only criteria. It's a little bit like a, I wouldn't say black box here, because LinkedIn has blue, so it's a blue box. So you do your application and so you hope that it works. But there is something that I found here. At least 150 followers or page connections are required, and a history of a recent, that you have shared original content, so that you have not only forwarded things, but that you're also created things that contribute with an original new thought. Then experience on this creation, whether it be posts, videos, articles on LinkedIn. And well, this is quite blurry, but it says abide to community policy. So I think if you have, I think it's just like have a good track record. And I think, I assume everybody of us has that. But yeah, just to mention, and then outside of mainland China because of current business strategy and geopolitical decisions, I would say. And altogether, LinkedIn just wants to provide a safe and trustworthy environment for the content. And I think this is also what makes them strong, because wise content published on LinkedIn is especially successful here. But when we see how to get a LinkedIn access, this is, I think it all comes down to, could you contribute to something original, and are you in a trustworthy, do you contribute to this trustworthy environment of LinkedIn? And of course, this makes it strong, right, Brian, for if you apply, it's the same thing. This is also to the benefit of everybody, because if you're posting something, there is this, there is this level of trust. So you can only have one profile, and you have published something already. Yeah, so you can see what's your job record. Yeah, I think this.
And that's one of the things interesting. You brought that up too, Daniel, but you can have one profile. And man, that's where you can get tricky sometimes, because if you're multi-talented and you're doing a lot of different things, sometimes it's hard to really nail down and focus. And so, you know, that's a whole nother thing to consider, but that's another opportunity for lives. Once you are following those, once you are in the club, if you will, in, right? The LinkedIn in the club, and you're approved as you are, then you're able to really have folks dialed in, because you do have one profile, you are speaking one message, one purpose, one platform, and it becomes more engaging as well. So,
and you need like this authorization stamp here from LinkedIn, and this is how it looks like. So you cannot go live before you have this authorization and you can be ready to go live. Now the question is, how do you do it? And this is the walkthrough guide now. So you type in request LinkedIn Live. So you come to the LinkedIn help page. From the LinkedIn help page, it's now quite simple. When I did it, there were a lot of questions. Like it's okay, what is your, what were the questions? What? Oh yeah, so they wanted to have proof at that time and video examples of recent videos that you did live. So they don't even have this anymore. What's required is your first, last name, email, and then your profile address. Normally it starts LinkedIn/EIN and then your name or your LinkedIn name. If you like to type this in, here's the address and the QR code to this LinkedIn page. Feel free to scan it in with your cell phone and you get there directly. And then the next step is, let's take a little break here. Remain patient. We don't know when this comes. So I had actually a quite relaxed approach. I did it in September last year and I received it, I think, quite quickly in December. LinkedIn has now refurbished their processes. It could be that it's done in 3 days, but also remain patient if it doesn't come. This said, I would say also ask regularly. Because what I hear is that a lot of people have been turned off, like their first LinkedIn application, because they thought, okay, LinkedIn hasn't answered. I think you have to show persistence. I think the more you ask, and this is what I hear, the higher the probability you will get the access. Maybe it's a human thing, so maybe the people see they're really engaged, so okay, they say, okay, let's give it a shot to this person. Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's not some fly by night. You know, I think you see that a lot if you're in digital marketing or if you're in sales in general. You know, you wanna, when there's a name drop going on, you know, you wanna make sure it's a good name drop, or if it's a good affiliate or someone, you know, that you really wanna do business with that's gonna represent your brand well. And ultimately, if someone's just flippantly applying for everything without any real idea of what they're gonna, how they're gonna execute, not just have a strategy, but how they're gonna execute it, then yeah, LinkedIn's kind of going, not yet, you know, keep coming back. But like in your case, you know, persistence, my mom taught me years ago, one of my first jobs, and persistence pays off. And I remember calling this guy Joe Barron every day. He was at an amusement park in Pittsburgh, PA, where I'm from. And Joe, hey, it's Brian again. All right, someone hire this kid. Let's call, quick call.
Exactly, you know? The same thing. So give this person a LinkedIn access. And so then use it. And these are the settings. It's a little bit tech oriented here, but I just included that. If you're watching this right now, it's just handy to have. So have like this here, this HD resolution when you set it up. You can have a look at this. It's just, I think, this minimum requirement here that you need to fulfill, and then run a speed test if you do your first LinkedIn Live, because you should have an upload speed of at least 10 megabyte per second. And then it's like some basic numbers here, 30 frames per second, and then HD quality, which is 720 pixel by 1080 pixel. And then the rest, so you can see here. And normally it's already also in included in the standard settings of these broadcasting tools. And here comes the second thing that I will introduce to you. First, you need to apply, and then you have to have a broadcast solution, platform or a cloud-based service that you use for streaming. LinkedIn divides into two different areas here. They have a preferred partner list of predominantly cloud-based providers. They are called StreamYard, Social Life, Switcher Studio, Restream. I'm also using Restream here to multi-stream. And then you have also a list, a whole wide list of certified partners. And I'm not going through the list, but I will highlight this here in the middle. This is called Ecamm Live, and you have heard it in my past live videos. I'm using this service. It's a software and on-site solution here that you could use. And Brian, you're using this as well. We are both heavy users of this, because you can also use it as a virtual cam for your webinars. Then you can add overlays, so you can just record stuff. It's a super versatile thing
Yeah, I absolutely use it for even just my static or non-live, you know, video suites for whether my courses or things that I want to share with people. So it's fun too, by the way.
Yeah. If people are watching this now and they're asking, okay, should I get it? And they have a PC, then of course, this is a little a downside. It's only available to Mac. But however, if you have a Mac, then it's an absolute fun thing. This is why I will also include later on in the demo a tool which is called OBS, Open Broadcast System, which is like a system that can run on any platform and is also free. So we have here this little slight preference for Ecamm, but it's possible for other broadcasting tools as well. To the demo part, which was basically set up 5 minutes and before this whole thing started. So here we come to OBS, the freeware and available for PC and Mac. Hey, Brian, I can put you here in the Ecamm Live logo. It looks perfect. I put myself here in the OBS studio. So you can use that as a great start, because I know people who say, well, do not want to invest so much at the start. So use OBS. It's a great way. If you have a little bit time to check out how things are working, it's working as well. Here you have the download link and you're ready to go. Then you have Ecamm, which is a paid service, but it also offers a lot for that, including virtual cam and overlays and all interview features that way what we are doing right now. And let's just jump right in the first demo. So this is where you access on LinkedIn, where you prepare your live stream. And so you type in the stream details, you choose your region, and then you receive a stream URL and a stream key. Then you put this in to OBS, and this is here the OBS display here and settings. And yeah, so then the LinkedIn page where we are on shows you the signal from OBS, and you would be ready to go live. If you go on the top right here of this picture, you could go live. That's it.
Very nice. I mean, I love how you're sharing and showing all this, because honestly, guys, anyone listening to this is a big hurdle for a lot of people I work with. They see this and they get overwhelmed. Don't. Mm-hmm. Daniel's walking you through this. It's not difficult, and you just crawl, walk, run. And so I really want to encourage you. You have a message to share. You have a purpose. You have a reason to get onto these lives and do these. Don't let this be a hurdle for you. It definitely is something to keep going with.
Thanks, Brian, because you have something you really want to share. So it doesn't have to be a cost intensive thing. You can do this with OBS, and here this is OBS. You can also have different camera perspectives. You can have overlays. It's possible. And then you can go out and reach out on LinkedIn. And I'm saying this especially also because I'm constantly also doing things for nonprofits and to show nonprofits how they can reach out to, make their mission heard. So this is a way to reach out on LinkedIn. Think about that. If you have a fundraising for your purpose, go for it. It doesn't cost you anything. It's just like the installation, and it's so fast. And now let's go into the Ecamm Live environment. And so this is a computer that I just set up new. And this is how you do it. You have Ecamm Live. So here we have this little part here where you have on the right, it's called destination. You click on and you then receive the login part for LinkedIn, and you choose my profile instead of organization, because most of us have a private profile. And this is of course all given the fact that you have already applied for access, right? So you are approved by LinkedIn, and then you are finding yourself in Ecamm, or you're also installing the free version of Ecamm. They have like trial version, so you can then set this up just so quickly. And then you go to my profile, so you add your email address and your password. I just skipped that. And then that's an important thing. This is something that is required for LinkedIn Live. You need to have a two-way authentication to make sure that nobody is using your password and streams with your credentials. So you need to have like a authentication app installed on your cell phone, and then you type in this code that you receive, and then you're logging in, and that's it. So you're just typing in the code, and just takes a little bit. Yeah, oh, look, this is even the code, but it's not valid anymore. And so you're in, and it says, hello, you're ready to go live with LinkedIn, and you can go and start. So this is it. So this was the demo part. I hope you liked this video. Please find further information on where to apply for LinkedIn Live and the contact to Brian in the show notes of this video. Would you like to know more about best practices of going live with LinkedIn? Then check out the best practices of going live with LinkedIn. Also, make sure to subscribe my channel to see related topics of going live and stay informed on new videos.